Today's sports coverage of the NFL takes us to the Carolinas and Bank of America Stadium here in Uptown Charlotte. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerged from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. The final playoff push is upon us. It's week 12 of the NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. A fairly short kick from the 14, and makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Carry for Christian McCaffrey. And some space here. Able to slither by. And he takes it all the way down to the 32. 45 yards on the ground for him so far. He's had his eyes on 7,000 career rushing yards, and with that last effort, he has hit that mark. What a career.
And that is the number to focus in on, because oftentimes we talk about where do they rank all time. We're not there yet. He's not knocking on the top 10 or the top 20, but over 7,000 yards in a career, fantastic.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Good job there to locate his tight end, Charles, in the middle of the field.
Yeah, he has good pass-catching abilities, and if they're able to continue to find him here in the early going, I think it'll help out his teammates out on the perimeter. You can take the big shots later if he occupies their attention.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
All right, Brent, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. They'll give it up to McCaffrey. They'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about 3.
Vision is so important for the man in the middle, because his ability to look through all the clutter that's happening in front of him, diagnose a play, and then go make it and finish it, that's when the great ones know that they have the goods.
One that's intercepted. Bernardrick McKinney, the linebacker, picks it. And the Bucs are going to get the football here as they force the INT on the game's opening drive. They'll start the drive with Harris. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 10, right around the 9-yard line. Shaq Thompson on the tackle that time.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description, because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
They try to set up the bubble screen here. It's complete. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. That's probably as simple of a throw as he'll have all game.
And good for everyone. Good for his completion percentage. Good for the receptions for the receivers. But you know how they work on that. They have footballs with no laces. So that as soon as you get the snap, you're just throwing the football. All right? You're not trying to find the laces and grip it a certain way. That takes time. Just get the ball and throw it. So that's how they practice it all the time now, too.
On second down, this is Harris. And this is going to be a Bucs first down as he gets it up past the 35.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down, keep the sticks moving.
Play action, now Kaepernick. He'll buy some time right. Open man is Trey Burton. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Flushed out right. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far at second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Second and 10. Shotgun snap now for Kaepernick. That's swung out wide to Harris. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get it out to your running back and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
Play number 7 now coming up on the drive. Third and 5. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Landry.
And he is going to have a Bucs first down by about a yard as they find a way to convert there on third down and 5.
That throw's not going to get them a whole lot, but that really didn't matter, did it? They got what they needed on that throw. Picked up the first down, and I'm going cliche here. Game of inches, partner.
Absolutely. Well, and you talked to me a lot about opening drives, how key those are to set the tone. You kept the drive alive. Third down conversion here is big.
Now a throw here to his running back. Oh, that's just not fair, and now room to run. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15.
That turned into a very well-orchestrated play right there. Going to work his way out of the backfield to the right, and after he looked it in, he found plenty of space to roam and picked up big yardage.
He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
And a lot of times these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
First down marker at the 5. It's second and goal. Immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a 3rd and 1. Remember, as they try to run the ball down here, Charles, this is the number 2 rush defense in the league.
So do you accept the challenge up front? Do you get your offensive line together, get your tight end in the ball game, and say, I don't care that they're number 2. Let's go ahead and show them that we can run the ball anyway. Or do you do the best thing and throw the darn thing and try and get in the end zone?
Maybe that's wiser.
And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on 4th and 1. They're going for it. This is Harris. And he has the first down before he's tackled at the 5.
There wasn't even thought of a short field goal. There was no hesitation. They were going for it.
I think he was thinking ahead a couple plays ago that if he got in this situation, they were definitely going for it. And you're right. It was a confident call and a decisive run to pick it up.
Eluding the pressure right. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
Second down now. It's Harris. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. A great effort there with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Buccaneers go coast to coast and finish the drive off with 6 points. Santos able to tack on the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0. Touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away.
taken at the 15, a short kick. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Their dreams of an undefeated season shattered with the loss a week ago. Now, look, whenever an undefeated team goes down, you always hear some say, well, they needed that. I don't know, Charles, is that a narrative that you buy into?
Well, I haven't met a coach yet that feels like they needed that loss. You know, that's not something that they're in favor of. But I do know this. People like us, our colleagues, all of us in the media, constantly hammering a team that's undefeated. Hey, do you think you can do it the whole season? Can you carry it the whole way? That does wear down a group, and sometimes that loss, get us off your back, you can move forward from there.
Second and six, just inside the 30. Shotgun handoff now to McCaffrey. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 66 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here in this first half. His first carry of their second drive, pretty solid. And, of course, remember back to their first drive, really strong throughout that one.
Not only is he getting good blocking up front, but how about his vision to find the holes? And he's seeing things before they even open and hurdling through them.
And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four, second and six.
Well, in every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a four-yard run on first down.
That catch good for five. It's third down. Pressure gets to McCaffrey as they stop him short of the line to gain. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one. Well, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jordan Poyer. And they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line. So after the INT, it's Kaepernick. Steps away to his left. It's a loss of 11 on the play. And it'll be a second and long. They fake the give. Now Kaepernick. This is caught by Evans. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A big connection on that one. 36 yards. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. From the gun, it's Kaepernick. Flush to his right. And he'll just get rid of it. They don't get the hook up there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's the perfect word for it, precise. Because if you're at 70% or better 2 weeks in a row, you have a job as long as you want one in this league, won't you? I mean, let's face it, it's not just West Coast offense either. He's putting the ball downfield as well.
And down inside the 15, shy of the 10.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Now Kaepernick. And that's incomplete.
No sense risking anything there on first down, even though he's still in the pocket. He had a receiver out to his side, so just put that in a spot where the only people who could make a play on it are the trainers and the coaches. Well done.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. A run with Harris out of the shotgun. Down to the 6-yard line on a pickup of 6 as he gets halfway to the goal line. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Burts has it left side. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And that's going to bring up a fourth down. On the run, it's Fournette. And not only did he not get in the end zone, he didn't get the first down either. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down. And that will force a turnover on downs. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And two interceptions thrown here in this first half. You hear it, no matter the sport, they say the great athletes, they can kind of have a short-term memory, but that's easier said than done.
It is easier said than done, but I played with a guy who threw two interceptions in the first quarter of a really big game we were playing.
Johnny Unitas?
And no, not quite of that level and not of that age. But I remember
going for the age.
I remember looking over at him, and he was smiling. And I thought, what is he smiling about? It's because he had enough confidence in himself that was a fluke. And he went out and played pretty well the rest of the day.
And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4, 2nd and 6.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
On second down, McCaffrey. And this is going to be a Panthers first down as he'll take this forward to the 27.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Now they'll throw with Tagovailoa. He's got Anderson right side. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Looking to pass, Tua. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. Now that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. Throwing again on second down, Tua. And he'll air this one deep for Anderson. Oh, and Tua going to be intercepted for the third time. Picked off by Jordan Poyer. And the Buccaneers are going to get it back here just shy of the 20. Well, Charles, you know, so close to halftime there. You throw the interception. Not only that, you do give it to them in plus territory as well.
Yeah, they were pushing real hard to try and get something more on the board on their side of the ledger right before the half. Looking at it with 20-20 hindsight, though, might have been better to hand it off a few times, hoping to get something to break instead of putting the ball in the air and, of course, putting the ball in jeopardy.
The ball comes out, but this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same.
I don't know about you, but I could hear and feel the sigh of relief all the way up here in our booth.
That was palpable. The sideline, the friend there.
No doubt about it. If ball goes over the sideline, able to retain possession, no turnover. I know his coaches are screaming, just hang on to the ball, man.
Second and short now following the fumble. This time they'll just keep this on the ground. And he's going to have a first down, but not sure it'll matter as the clock will continue to run. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. On play action, it's Kaepernick. Going deep here for Landry. That's caught inside the 20. Yeah, he's going to get this deep on a Carolina side of the field. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. To throw is Kaepernick. Throw left side, going to be taken in by Harris. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting Buccaneers out on top. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. With a lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And this return will net positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. Offense set to begin their next possession. Their defense has pitched the shutout. Now they probably need to deliver a little breathing room, maybe make it a two-score game as they've got it first and 10. And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication, and as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating, there he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
And this is going to be a Bucs first down as good running gets him to about the 44.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game. First down, Drake. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Speed is the name of the game when it comes to RPOs, and sometimes you can be a little too quick, thus inaccurate, incomplete.
An important play right here, 3rd and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
On 3rd and long, it's Kaepernick. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked off by Nasir Adderley. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line. That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind. And we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Couldn't you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5.
It's a gain of 5. Brings up 2nd and 5.
They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. And a nice run. They're going to take this close to the first down mark. At the Bucs 25. Taken down, but he does have first down yardage.
Someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? A lot of it's been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he'll keep it moving down to the 15-yard line. 114 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. 3 yards remain for second down. This is McCaffrey on the give. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up. On play action, here's Tua. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
And his kick is good. And they're on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So a good kick there, and they put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defenses are awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the three.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are.
And I think the ball's out, and it's picked up by the Panthers. So turnovers, Charles, you figure will be key in the second half, and that's a big giveaway there.
Yeah, and as you and I both know, coaches are always preaching ball security, and none more often than right here in the second half of a tight football game. Now you've got to believe what the coaches are saying and take care of that football.
Following the fumble recovery, here's Tua. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
That was nice work there defensively to force the incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
The line to gain is the 33 on third down. From the gun, it's Tua. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Casey Hayward. And the Bucs are going to get the football here at their own 23. This home crowd, they're happy with that call.
I like the way you said happy there, right? The so-called good guys didn't get a call. They feel like it's been that way all afternoon. You feeling their pain?
They finally got one.
Yes, they did.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. McCaffrey. And he'll get about 3 as he's taken down at the 14-yard line.
Not a big run on the first play of the drive, but that doesn't necessarily mean it was a bad play. Sometimes you're just trying to settle in, get your guys a little bit of contact, and get things moving.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. Open man left side. It's the tight end Trimble. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. That catch good for 5. It's 3rd down.
Very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short.
Here we go with McCaffrey. And he gets the first down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the 6. So a moment to catch our collective breath after the 4th down conversion. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown, and that's what they're gunning for on 1st and goal. They'll try to run with McCaffrey, and he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Christian McCaffrey with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Panthers have taken the lead. Now an important extra point here to stretch this lead to a field goal. He's got it, and this is indeed up to a three-point lead. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown. Their defense just surrendered. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off at the 24. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown. Short throw pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
Extra point splits the uprights, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. We'll see if they can band back together after the pick six. It hurt badly, but still within striking distance. A two-score game with a good chunk of time on the clock. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. 61 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. To throw, Kaepernick. It's hauled in by Shepard. A gain of 6 there on 1st.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. Now a play fake. Kaepernick. Dancing to his left. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away. On 3rd down, they've only converted once in 4 tries. This is 3rd and 4. Kaepernick gonna throw. Well, this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now 4th down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
I tell you, they didn't give it to him much for the 1st 3 quarters, but when they have, he's been efficient. Maybe they ride him more here down the stretch.
Yeah, not sure it was actually in the game plan for him to have as few carries as he has, but it might play out really well for them now. As you noted, if they want to ride him down the stretch, he should have fresh legs.
Escaping the pressure right. He's going to look deep now for Landry. And that is incomplete.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10.
What's that?
Kaepernick now to throw. Flushed out right. And that's complete to Shepard. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
Well, every drive from here out is definitely crucial and critical. They know that they need to get at least three here to get it back to a one-score game. But I can't imagine that in their huddle that they're thinking at all about getting a field goal. They want to get into the end zone and then try and get the ball back again.
And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down. Second and 10 now from the 27. Here's Kaepernick. Gonna throw deep for the end zone. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield.
Now the Panthers gonna use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. To throw, it's Kaepernick. He gets it complete to Harris. And they're going to stop him short of the first down as he's tackled at about the 21. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. On the left hash mark, this a 38-yard attempt. Santos' kick is up and through. And they're back within a touchdown. It's 17 to 10.
Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. The field goal we just saw has this now at a one-score game, and on this side of the football, things are getting pretty tenuous, a little stressful.
Blood pressure up a little bit, you think?
I think up a lot of it.
Could you imagine taking a pulse right now? It would be like a jackhammer out there on that side of the ball, but here's what the deal is. I think what we've observed is a team that's been playing not to lose as opposed to playing to win. And they've got to get back to that, and that means opening things up again, being a little more free in what they're trying to get done on offense.
Tua's throw here into the hands of Moore.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to.
And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted.
Picked by Antoine Winfield Jr. And the Buccaneers are right back in this football game.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. The interception sets them up with an opportunity to erase this fourth quarter deficit. Now this series could very well determine our outcome. A throw left side to start the drive is complete. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. A handoff out of the pistol, it's Drake. And he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
And he'll muscle his way up to the 43 for a pickup of right around five.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They face a critical third down now, needing a score here in the late going. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now.
The run only got a yard, here's second and nine. Now Kaepernick. Eluding the pressure right. And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down. Third and long coming up defensively. You pressure the quarterback or Drake all over the passing lane?
Yes, that's exactly what you do. It's both because they're not mutually exclusive. They may have been at one time in football, but not anymore. You want to have that pressure. If you have a big-time pass rusher, send him after the quarterback, and then make sure you blanket the field.
Able to find Ertz, and he's going to come up a few yards short. Brought down at the 45. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth. They're making steady progress, but I see your face. You're worried about that clock.
I'm worried about the clock, and at some point, you have to have a splash play in there as well.
Down seven, and they've got to go for it here on fourth down. And boy, is he close. Did he get there? No, they're going to say he's short of the line to gain. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Panthers are going to win the football game. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And this game not quite in hand yet. We'll likely see all three timeouts defensively and then reassess where we are. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in the fourth. So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 45 seconds left to go in the game. They'll give it up to McCaffrey, and he gets this only to the 44-yard line. Not near enough to keep the drive alive. The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. Now on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. And that hits at the six and carries into the end zone for a touchback. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. One possession game, time very much a factor. How does the offense handle it? And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. After the sack, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town. It's second and a country mile. He's going to let it fly. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked up by Jordan Whitehead. And the Panthers are going to hang on the final play. They get the turnover to seal this football game. Well, we were on hand for a fun and entertaining game here, coming down really to that last play. Great job defensively to get the pick and seal it.
And we know that every play during a game matters. You're never sure which one's going to be one of the key ones. But at the end of the game, when you analyze it, three, four, five plays are going to be the focus on. And that last play was one of them. The last shot had to take it, and they came up with the interception and sealed their victory.
So for Carolina, they get win number 10 on the year as they move to 10-1. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Houston Texans. Meanwhile, for the Bucs, it's starting to look like it won't be their year as they drop to 5-6. And they'll try to make amends next week as they host the New Orleans Saints. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.